young people that are here tonight, and several years back, one of the young men in our church was saved, gloriously saved. He's 18 years old, and it was 2 weeks before graduation, and his buddy came and said, "Let's take a ride. I got a brand new car for graduation." A mile and a half from their home, they were hit by a reckless driver. And Matthew, 18 years old, 6'2", size 12 shoe, his life was terminated that day, and he went home to be with the Lord. He was an athlete, had a charismatic personality. When Matthew walked in the room, everybody just smiled, and he would light a room up. So the high school said, "We don't want to have graduation because if Matt won't be here, it just won't be the same." They brought in school counselors, school psychologists, and all the people they could find to help reason with these young people. The high school principal went to the superintendent and said, "Can we have a memorial service? We've got to bring some closure." Superintendent said, "You know the rules. This is a public school. You can talk about God and you can talk about heaven, but you can't use the Bible and you can't talk about Jesus because Jesus doesn't include everybody." They called a Catholic priest, a Baptist pastor, called myself. But a couple of days before this event was to take place, the Lord spoke to me and said, "Ask if you can sing. Sometimes if you can't preach it, if you can't talk it, if you can't say it, if you can't dramatize it, if you can't put it in a pamphlet, God will give you an opportunity to sing this wonderful message of the gospel of Jesus." It's 11 o'clock during the day. There were over 700 students that came voluntarily during that school day. Catholic priest said wonderful things about God and about heaven. The Baptist pastor said wonderful things about God and heaven. It was my turn to talk about God and heaven, but before I did, this is the song I sang. Oh, out there. Thought it was cool to keep taking chances, thinking they'd never lose. They're hooked on a feeling that's left them empty hands. Somebody out there who can't quite decide, oh, whether to live, whether to die. They're searching for strength to make it through their crisis in life. Out there.